السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. لسنا في المدرسة الثانية حل one step equations. Solving one step equations. In this lesson, we have two ideas. We want to at first learn solve equations by using addition and subtraction. And the second idea, we want to learn solve equations by using multiplication and division. So I want from or to open your notebook in a new page, please, and write the title solving one step equations. Please write this title. We have two ideas in this lesson. Who can remember us what the meaning of the solution? Or solution? Solution or solution? What does that mean? What the answer of what?
Finding x.
The answer of what?
The value of the variable.
Where? In the exhibition, in the equation, in the equation. So the solution, the value of the variable inside the equation. Right? And so write with us. Write the title in a new page. نكتب معي يمين كل يكتب معي بدون استثناء على صفحة جديدة نكتب العنوان What the meaning of equivalent equations? The first idea, we want to learn how to solve equations by using addition and subtraction. So write this title, please. Solving one step equations involving addition or subtraction. To solve an equation means to find all values of the variable that make the equation true. And equivalent equations have the same value. So I want from all to write the definitions here. What is the meaning of the solution and what is the meaning of the equivalent equation? So who can tell us what is the meaning of the solution? Excellent. And what is the meaning of the equivalent equations? Have the same solution. The solution يعني الحل للإكويجن. هلا الإكويجن فيها variable صح؟ X أو Y أو Z. طيب إذا أنت حليت الإكويجن وعرفت قيمته لها X مثلا X equal 5 X equal 3 شو بتسمي هي X equal 3 شو بنسميها؟ solution تمام؟ فهي قيمة الفاريبل the value of the variable inside the equation. أما الإكويفلنت إكويجنز يعني المعادلات المتكافئة يعني اللي لها نفس كل المعادلات اللي لها نفس قيمة الفاريبل شو بنسميها؟ إكويفلنت إكويجنز تمام؟ اللي بالأزرق تمام أول شيء كتبنا العنوان سولفينج بعدين نكتب التعريف تبع السولوشن والتعريف تبع الإكويفلنت Now we want to learn the technique, the strategy to solve any equation using addition or subtraction. Using addition or subtraction. خطوة خطوة. أنا كتبت لي التعريفين. طب هلا بدنا نتعلم الاستراتيجية أو التكنيك، يعني طريقة حل الإيكويجن باستخدام الـ addition أو the subtraction، استخدام الإضافة أو الفرق. تمام؟ طيب listen here please. If a number is added to each side of a true equation, the resulting equivalent equation is also true. For example, for any real numbers, if you have A, B, and C, if A equal B, then if I add the same number to the two sides, A plus C here and B plus C here, the equal will be true. مثل لما نشوف نحن الميزان اللي له كفتين. تعرفون الميزان اللي له كفتين؟ طيب اذا كان متوازن، يعني الكفه اليمين تساوي الكفه اليسار. طيب اذا ضفت للكفه الاولى كيلو، ضفت للكفه الثانيه كيلو، هل يتغير التوازن؟
لا
ما بيتغير. ضفت 2 كيلو لهون 2 كيلو لهون، هل يتغير التوازن؟
لا
ما بيتغير. معناتها عند اضافه نفس العدد الى طرفي الايكويجن تبقى الايكويجن صحيحه. تمام؟ إذا هاي أول خاصة، هاي أول خاصة نكتبها. نعم. ايه موجوده بالكتاب، بس الكتاب الدرس بالكتاب 6 صفحات، فنحن عم ناخذ الشيء اللي بدنا اياه. تمام؟ عم ناخذ الافكار اللي بدنا فقط، يعني بحيث انه نحن نلخص الدرس صفحه او صفحه ونص، يعني بس صفحتين بالكثير. طيب the same idea, but if a number is subtracted from each side of a true equation, the resulting equivalent equation is also true. For any real numbers like A, B, and C, if we have the equation A equal B, then if I subtract the same number from the two sides of this true equation, A minus C and here B minus C, you will be find the true equation. The true equation. إذا معناته أنا إذا قمت نفس المقدار من الطرفين تبقى الإيكويجن صحيحة. إذا طرحت أو قمت أو عملت سبتراكت أو عملت ماينس نفس العدد أو نفس المقدار the same quantity from the two sides, we will get the same or the true equation. واضح شباب؟ زودوا لكم اياها 10 دقائق لانه شالوا البريك ثاني. مستعجل؟ انا ماني مستعجل. هلا بدنا نكتب هذا التيبل كاملا، هذا اكتب على مهلك ولا يهمك يا سيف. شو كم سيف عندنا نحن؟ تمام يا سالم؟ مفهوم الآن للشيء اللي حكيناه؟ واضح للجميع؟ في حدا عنده سؤال استفسار في شيء مو واضح؟ الاديشن بروبرتي والسبتراكشن بروبرتي. الاديشن بروبرتي انه انت اذا عندك ايكويشن، ايكويشن هي عباره عن شو؟ ايكوال بين تو سايدز، مساواه بين الطرفين، صح؟ انت اذا جبت نفس الرقم واضفته للطرفين، هل تتغير هذه المساواه؟ تبقى صحيحه، صح؟ نفس الوقت اذا عملت سبتراكشن او طرح نفس العدد من الطرفين، هل تتغير هذه المساواه؟ لا تتغير. هي بنسميها اديشن بروبرتي اند سبتراكشن بروبرتي. تمام؟ تمام يا محمد؟ اوكي تمام يا علي؟ انت عندك 2 بلس 5 يكمل 1 بلس 6 صح؟ 2 بلس 5 7 1 بلس 6 7 طيب على سبيل المثال انت اضفت نفس العدد، جبت عدد مثلا 3 وضفته للطرفين نص 3 نص 3، تغير شيء المساواه ولا تصير خاطئه؟ تظل صحيحه من هيك؟ فاعزمي هون شو صار المجموع؟ 10، هون شو صار المجموع؟ 10. اذا ما بتتغير المساواه، اذا هي بنسميها من خواص المساواه، probability of addition، خواص المساواه. طيب نفس الشيء اذا عندك طرفين متساويين، اذا عندنا نفس الرقم، يعني جيت قلت هون عندنا ماينس 2 قلنا من هون ماينس 2، غيرت شيء المساواة؟ صار المجموع هون عندك A والمجموع عندك هون B، لاحظ المساواة طلعت صحيحة، ما تغيرت. هاي اسمها من خواص شو؟ Equations اللي هي probabilities of subtraction. وضحت هيك؟ تمام. في حدا لسه عم يكتب؟ بسرعة شوي. ليس اذا الرؤيه صعبه عليك ليش خلف ميلاد؟ قرب شوي. تمام؟ طيب خلينا نشوف let us to see some examples. طيب the first example here solve by adding use the addition property of equality to solve this is the equation as you see here g minus 25 equal 130 who tell us what is the variable here g do you know the variable the value of this variable so the goal here we want to solve this equation to know the value of the variable. طيب as you see we have two method horizontal method this is the equation g minus 25 equal 30 هلا if you add the same number to the two sides you will get this the true equation right so always when you want to solve any equation try to keep the variable alone in the side and try to remove any number with the variable what is the variable here g and here we have constant we want to remove this constant how to remove negative 25 add the inverse what is the inverse of negative 25 positive 25 so add 25 to the two sides add 25 to the two sides When you add the same number to the two sides, you will get a true equation. This is the probability of addition. Now, negative 25 and the plus positive 25 will be what? Will be zero. Remains here G and 113 plus 25 will be 138. So now we know now the value of the variable. What is the value of the variable here? G equal 138. When you know the variable, what is the name of this form now? The solution of the equation. The name of G equal 138, Ya Mansoor, the solution of the equation. Right. The second method, vertical method, do the same idea but vertically. Add the same number to the two sides, plus 25 here and plus 25 here. Minus 25 and plus 25 will be what? Will be zero, it means G. And 113 plus 25 will be 138. So G equal 138. Right. How to know if our solution is true or not? We can do check. You can substitute the value of the variable or the solution inside the equation. If you get a true equation, means you have a true solution. And if you get a wrong equation, means you have wrong solution. Listen here, we have this equation. Substitute the value of G, 138 minus 25. Is it equal 113? Check. 138 minus 25 will be 113. So yes, 113 equal 113 means we have a right solution. So I want to from all write the first example of this.
How is this additional property? How is this additional property?
From what?
From equation, how is this additional property?
As you see here, we have negative 25, and you add the inverse. When you add the inverse, you use what? The additional property, because you add the same number to the two sides. Okay? يعني الاديشنال بروبرتي انه انت اذا ضفت نفس العدد لطرفي الايكويجن تبقى الايكويجن صحيح، هذه هي معناته الاديشنال بروبرتي. بنفس الوقت السبتراكشن بروبرتي يعني اذا انت عملت ماينس لنفس العدد من الطرفين تبقى الايكويجن صحيحه لا تتغير. لا تتغير بالمساوات، يبقى الطرف الايمن مساوي للطرف الايسر، هذا المقصود. تمام؟ فانا بدي استخدم هاي الخاصيه في حل And I want to from all to try to solve this equation, find the value of W, try in case. Then after you solve this, after you solve in this equation, tell me what is the name of this property. Try for that. This equation.
Very number of sort of the end of this number. Please don't.
What is the name of this number? Next number, next number. This is one number, not two numbers. This is one number, rule and the fraction, one and a half, okay?
So I found the number, not the direct number, the name. I found the fraction of the one up to one over two minus two over three, but I don't know what it's called.
The value, one?
One and one over two. Minus two.
Minus two. What is the name of this property? What you use additional or subtractional? Subtractional property.
The R. W equal five over.
W equals one?
Five.
Over four.
Six.
Six. Now you listen. Listen. If you have fraction, you have mixed number. You can change from mixed number to the fraction. So rewrite two over three was W equal. How to compare?
One times two plus one.
One times two plus one. One times two, two. Two plus one,
three over two.
So we have three over two. Then always remember, when you want to solve any equation, try to keep the variable alone at the same side. So try to remove the numbers from the same side of the variable. How to remove two over three?
The opposite.
What is the inverse?
Point.
I get it. So we can here. We can subtract, give it the two over three from the two sides. Okay? Now, negative 2 over 3 plus 2 over 3?
0.
0. It means W. How to add two fractions?
We multiply the denominator.
Have different denominators or allied fractions. We can switch. Take 3 multiplied by 3 and give multiplied by 3. Rewrite. Multiply the first fraction by 3. 3 times 3.
9.
3 times 2.
6.
Minus 2 times 2.
4.
Or yeah, so.
It's 6.
2 times 3. 6. Now, as you see, you have the same denominator. You have like fractions. Now you can subtract. So we write them to equal 9 minus 4. 5.
Over 6.
The same, and I will add you to my screen. Okay?
Do you understand?
Yes, you can write it.
Okay.
So. And after you do the operation here, write the name of the property, the last one. This is the name of this property, okay? We use subtraction property of
A with
D, number D. Sorry, we have wrong here. The answer 5 over 6, subtraction property is number A. We have here wrong.
Number A, yes. Great
the last thing.
Done. كده خلاص. طيب ضل عنا الخاصة الثانية. نحن إلا درس فكرتين صح؟ أخذنا addition and subtraction. شو ضل علينا؟ multiplication and
division.
طيب كتب العنوان الثاني. Solving one-step equations involving multiplication or division. هلا الخاصة الأولى the first property multiplication property of equality. If an equation is true and each side is multiplied by the same non-zero number, then the resulting equation is equivalent. أول شيء كتبنا العنوان زين بعد العنوان نكتب التابل الأول. For any real numbers a, b, and c, if we have a equal b, if you multiply the same number by the two sides of this equation, you will get a true equation. As you see, we have a, c equal b, c. For example, suppose we have this equation x equal 3. If you multiply the two sides by the same number like 8, 8 times x, 8x, 8 times 3 will be 24. You will get the true equation right here. If you have x equal 6, this is the equation. If you choose number like 5, if you multiply the two sides by the same number, what happened, as you see? 5 times x, 5x, and 5 times 6 there. You will get the true equation. No change in the equality. And the same idea for division, but must to be careful when you divide. You can divide by any number without the zero, without zero. Because if you divide any number by zero, you will get undefined. So also write this table. شوف أنا بكرة بدي أفتش عدة أختار إذا بلاقي نقص في نقص على نقص شوفوا بسرعة نفسك If an equation is true and each side is divided by the same non-zero number, the resulting equation is equivalent for any real number like A, B, and C, but C doesn't equal zero. This is very important. If A equal B, this equation, then if you divide the two sides by the same number, you will get the true equation A divided by C equal B divided by C. For example, if you have x equal negative 35 and you divide the two sides by 7, x over 7 equal negative 35 over 7 or negative 5 because negative 35 divided by 7 equal negative 5. Today, inshallah, we have homework about this ideas. I will send in the group some practice about how to solve the equation using additional, property, subtractional, property and multiplication and divide property. Who has any question about this properties? No questions? Okay. So this is our video for today. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day. See you tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.